to America by rail.
If you do, then forgive me and make the world go away. Make the world go away.
Thank you. some guy just walked by me and saw me on the train and asked me if I had any bolt cutters or an angle grinder that he could buy from me because he had found a few loaded containers. Fucking ridiculous, man. Bakersfield. Alright, we're heading out of Bakersfield. Heading over to Hatch B down to LA. I should be there in the early evening or late afternoon. Somewhere out here, east of Bakersfield, California, doing absolutely nothing. We're having some sort of mechanical problem, I figure. The train crew changed like 3 hours ago in town, and then just kept moving, siding to siding, stopping for, you know, almost an hour at each one. And now we're all the way out here in the middle of nowhere. And we are not moving. And there are no trains coming by. A few vehicles drove up and down the track. I don't know. Either way, we're heading to LA. And I was hoping to be there late this afternoon, but now it's looking like we're gonna be there in the night. Alright, well, I'm somewhere out here east of Bakersfield, California. All sorts of weirdos hanging out near the train today. Two people over here with no vehicle. We're in the middle of nowhere. I think they got off the train, maybe? I don't know. Some guy walked by me earlier in the yard and asked me if I had bolt cutters or an angle grinder that I could sell him. Like, while I was on the train. And yeah, we've had a crew for 4 hours. We've gone 20 miles, you know? So I have no idea what's going on with this train right now. But we got a oncoming. So I'm really hoping. We're just waiting for this, and now we're gonna move. Yeah. All right, my train's sided out right here by the Loves in Tehachapi, California. I normally wouldn't risk it like this, but we've gone a painfully small amount of distance in 12 hours. And I actually think the crew might be timing out right now, and that's why we're stopped here, is they're gonna get a new crew. But either way, gave me the opportunity to buy myself some Coors Lattes and hop back on the train. Thank you, train gods. Nice little high-speed chase going down in the parking lot of the Loves right over here. Oh man, they got him. Oh, did they get him? Yeah, he ran into a snowbank. No, he's running, I think. Oh, there he is. It's nice to have a show with my beer. All right, we're stopped out here in Cajon Pass, coming into the greater LA area. Local time, 4 a.m. And believe it or not, even with all the snow and everything, those last 5 hours were the coldest I've been on this entire ride. I just got wet coming down yesterday through the valley. It dried up for a minute and then it rained all afternoon again. By the time we got to Tehachapi and sided out, I was just soaked, and it was probably it was definitely like below 40 there. Anyway, probably about one more hour left once we get moving, and I'm ready to get off this train. Holy hell! All right, we are finally entering Cajon Pass, heading into the LA area. We've been sitting right here since 3 a.m. It's now 10 a.m. That's 7 hours. I don't even know what to say, y'all. It's been over 24 hours since I was in Bakersfield. That's like a 2-hour drive by car from LA. But you know, it's always good to be setting new personal records and propelling yourself to greater heights and like bigger and better things, you know?
I'm 500 miles away from I know this is the same road I took the day I left home, but it sure looks different now. Well, I guess I look different too, 'cause time changes everything. I wonder what they'll say when they see their boy looking this way.
Oh, I wonder what they'll say when I get home. Can't remember when I ate. It's just thumb and walk and wait. And I'm still 500 miles away from home. If my luck had been just right, I'd be with them all tonight. But I'm still 500 miles away from home. Away from home, away from home. Cold and tired and all alone. Yes, I'm still 500 miles away from home. Oh, I'm still 500 miles away from home.
All right, I've landed in the LA area at Familiar CP Slover. And right now I'm waiting for one of my YouTube viewers, Brian, who I met down here last winter, to come pick me up over here in the same spot we met. And I think we might head up into Cajon Pass, just watch trains for the afternoon, eat some burritos, drink a few beers. But I will pretty quickly be getting geared up, heading back down to the yard, catch a train to Tucson for the Combat Rail Fans Revival New Year's 2021. I'm stoked, can't wait to be there. This is gonna be tighter than the nun's butthole, y'all.
Over.
Morning time here at West Colton Yard. And I have no agenda. I'm just waiting here to catch some sort of sign of a train that looks like an eastbound. And really, I'm not only waiting here, I'm walking between here and the overpass, and then looking down into the yard. And, yeah, you know, I got plenty of time at this point. This trip down here to Arizona will not be as long as the one last winter, and not as long as I anticipated. So, you know, whatever I do in the next 2 weeks of time that I have is fine with me, really. And then I'm just going to blast back up to Oregon through the grace of some good friends. I have a extremely affordable living scenario, so it really doesn't make sense for me to be out and about right now, rambling, you know, for 2 months like I normally would, because I can just go home and work and stack money and not really pay rent. So, yeah, pretty cool. And anyway, back to the trains. Cheers. I hope I'm on something over to Tucson today. All right, back up here on the bridge. I just identified my train. I'm pretty sure it's the same train I rode out of here last time I caught from Colton. Anyway, it doesn't leave for quite a few hours from what I figure, so I got time to get some food and make moves. Identified my train, just waiting for it to go. Refueling here at the gas station. All right, here we go. I've got a broken toe and it's all swollen up and purple right now. It's really slowing me down. So the name of the game here is going to be infiltrate the yard while it's still quiet and get on the train way before they start working it or doing anything, so that I don't have to do any running around. Like butter. All right, I've only been in here for like 20 minutes, and we just got some air put into the train, which is a good sign. And it's definitely the same train I rode last time to Tucson. And apparently these boxcars go to and from Mexico, and when they're coming to America, they're full of beer, like Sol and Pacifico. And that's how I know.
That your door is always open and your path is free to walk. That makes me tend to leave my sleeping bag rolled up and stashed behind your couch. And it's knowing I'm not shackled by forgotten words and bonds and the ink stains that are dried upon some line. That keeps you in the back roads by the rivers of my memory. It keeps you ever gentle on my mind. It's not clinging to the rocks and ivy planted on their columns now that bind me. Or something that somebody said because they thought we fit together walking. It's just knowing that the world will not be cursing or forgiving when I walk along some railroad track and find that you're moving on the back roads by the rivers of my memory, and for hours you're just gentle on my mind. Though the wheat fields and the clotheslines and the junkyards and the highways come between us, and some other woman's crying to her mother cause she turned and I was gone, I still might run in silence, tears of joy might stain my face, and a summer sun might burn me till I'm blind. But not to where I cannot see you walking on the back roads by the rivers flowing gentle on my mind. I dip my cup of soup back from a gurgling, crackling cauldron in some train yard. My beard a roughening coal pile and a dirty hat pulled low across my face. Through cupped hands round the tin can, I pretend to hold you to my breast and find that you're waiting from the back roads by the rivers of my memory. Ever smiling, ever gentle on my mind.
So I just talked to my friend Combat Jake, and whom I will be going to stay with tonight, and we'll be hanging out with the whole time I'm in Tucson probably. He's having some car problems right now, so he might not be down here to pick me up for a few hours. He lives right up by Saguaro National Park, which would be pretty cool. We can just go hiking and everything. But in the meantime, I realized that I am only about half a mile from an Eegee's. And if you know, you know. So I'm heading over there, get me a Slurpee and a sandwich. If you know, you know. Here with Combat Jake.
You ever went and looked for like bait deals or
anything? Yeah, I've walked this whole thing.
That's what's up.
Yeah, there's not much. Because they did do a, I don't know, maybe 1950 something. They fixed it a little bit. So
it's definitely a pretty spot to come out.
Oh yeah, even if you're just chilling. Like I was telling him, I come out here just ride my bike. Just on the track here on the stuff here. But,
so Jake, what was the history of this?
This was a old Southern Pacific water tank for Pantano, the town of Pantano.
How long has it been since it was used?
I don't remember.
Probably a long time though.
A while, yeah. I think talking like 40s at least, 40s, 50s.
I've camped out here a number of times. It's a great spot. There's a ton of like old bridges too, cement bridges over that direction. It's also really cool when you're out here and
I just want to point out for all of you that Big Ed here is chasing Jim Beam with Thunderbird in this photo. This is too cool.
Just hanging out in the backyard at my friend Combat Jake's house. Yeah, man, it's really nice to just be able to wake up in the morning and not think about where you are, whether some cops are gonna come kick you out, whether some tweaker is gonna come harass you or try to rob you or whatever, you know? Life is completely different when you can wake up in the morning and not immediately feel stress about what you have to do that day. And so I'm so thankful for Jake. Shout out. Appreciate you. And yeah, stoked to be here in Tucson and looking forward to the next 2 weeks. I've got a bum ankle for now though. All that running in and out of the yard in Colton and Tucson aggravated the previous injury. So I'm laying up here for another day or two, and then we're gonna get out and do some hiking and foaming. I really love all these photos.
Like right here. I'm wondering, is that urine or water?
Given he's right by the door, I'm gonna go with urine. But you never really know. It could be raining.
Alright, back out here with Combat Jake, doing a little rail fanning today. Gonna go check out some small yards and then just hit the main line for a while. Welcome to the town of Cochise, Arizona, named for the tribal leader, Chief Cochise. It's all within Cochise County, and this I used to live down here 10 years ago, and this is where I had my first Forest Service job, down in Douglas. Now we're just driving around, heading towards a town called Wilcox. Alright, we're out here on the Wilcox Playa. And this is effectively like a seasonal lake, but it won't fill up every year. And actually, really, it will rarely fill up. Jake, how much water did you say was in this thing?
This monsoon season, about 1 inch.
1 inch.
Distributed pretty evenly.
And they had more rain than they've had in 10 years. Yeah, yeah. So normally there's really no water here, but cool place to drive around. Yard in a small railroad town in eastern Arizona. Just putzing around. Thank you. have another rail fan out here.
Just hanging out back here in the wash, catching the morning rays, seeing who's been walking around. Had some roadrunners coming through here. let's see, recap. The past 5 days or whatever since I got into Tucson, I've just been hanging out with Combat Jake here. He's been taking really good care of me. Shout out to Combat Jake and his wife. Thank you guys a lot for putting me up and giving me showers and everything. Had a bum ankle the whole time I've been here, so I haven't gotten out and done a lot of hiking or anything, but we went up Mount Lemmon. We went out towards Wilcox and did a little rail fanning. Drove around out near Vail. Checked out some historic trackage near Cienega Creek. And yeah, today we are heading up to Picacho for a little more rail fanning. And we're going to spend the night there. And then tomorrow is Christmas Eve. So Jake is going to hang out with his family and I'm going to do something. Actually, I think my friend Gabe will be coming into town and we might rent a motel and do a little hobo Christmas party. But yeah, so far so good. I love Tucson. I love the Sonoran Desert. Out.
Amen, brother. You know, everywhere you go, Colorado, Idaho, Oregon, Washington, Arizona, Nevada, Utah, they all don't like Californians. It's so strange.
Yeah, there's really nothing down there on I-8.
Nope.
Quick stop at Picacha Peak Plaza. Thank you.